got an angel. She doesn't wear any wings. She wears a heart that can melt my own. She wears a smile that can make me wanna sing. She gives me presents with a presence alone.
Strong relationships. Stay connected to those that are important to us. So let us cherish this day as a celebration of love and friendship. The bride and groom would like to share a little bit about why they have chosen this venue for the evening. As these two embark today on a happy and loving marriage, they have also recently embarked on a slightly different, equally exciting journey, that of being new homeowners. Having now put roots down in the Connecticut Valley, Dan and Danielle thought it only appropriate that they celebrate their commitment to each other in the region as well, this being the place that they hope to raise a family and begin their married life. Inspiration from their vows today to one another, for when the world displays nothing but hatred, greed, and despair, God knows, use more love. Dan and Danielle, it is now my honor and delight to declare you husband and wife. May I seal your vows with a kiss?
Oh, 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 oh. Share the same soul. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, 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 oh. Mm-mm-mm-mm.
I wrote a few thoughts down. I knew I was drinking, so I want to make sure I do this the right way. I would like to start by welcoming you all and to thank you for coming here to celebrate this very special occasion, the marriage of Danielle and Dan. It is really great to see so many friends and family here today.
But there's one memory that stuck to me when I first met Danielle. It's a driver's ed. 10 minutes late, of course, by the way. And she was wearing jet black leggings, a dramatic fur black coat, a hot pink shirt with booties. And mind you, I was wearing sweatpants and a tank top. It was great. So this is at 7 at night, too. It was fantastic. She sat down next to me and said, "Hi." And rudely enough, I said hi back, and I wanted to be your friend. That was our whole conversation. Little did I know, a few months later, Danielle came to my parents' house to hang out with Dan. And I was like, "Oh, I know you." I'm like, "What are you doing, best friends?" The way that Dan looked at her, laughing uncontrollably every time they were together, and how much Danielle challenged him, I instantly knew that they were perfect for each other. Me and you have gotten so close over the years, and you've made my brother so happy, and my brother and I have gotten so much closer because of you. He's found the love of his life, and I finally have a sister. I love you guys both very, very much, and I wish you both the best. I'm so sorry. Congratulations, Dan and Danielle.
Thank you. everyone. As many of you know, I'm Andrew Merritt, and Dan is my cousin. I have to tell you, I'm a bit nervous tonight, as I've never been the best man before. So Dan and Danielle might be nervous as bride and groom, but I think I'm the most nervous. The first time Dan told me that I was going to be the best man, I said, why me? What do I know about being a best man? Well, not much, but I think I know more about being a best friend. Dan and I go way back. Although we grew up in different countries or different cities, and we didn't see each other as much as we would have liked, whenever we got together, or we get together, we always have a rocking great time together. Whether we were playing in the snow, snorkeling at the beach, playing video games, or heading out to eat, no matter what we do, it's always chill and great company. I think of Dan as another brother, one who isn't 6'4" like my other brother. He's my tan brother. I just can't say enough good things about Dan. He's my best bud now, and always will be. And I'm honored that he asked me to be his best man. Here's to you, Dan.
But yeah, it's been one hell of a night. Never in a million years that I think I'd be married at 27, but here I am, and I couldn't be happier. Before I give some things to some very special people, I just wanted to thank you all. I know how precious these summer weekends are and how valuable time is. So I'd just like to thank you for putting your life on pause for us to be here to celebrate with us. I don't know why I'm getting so emotional all of a sudden. Oh. Really, don't even like any of you that much.
Ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide.